Well, one of my next guests helped achieve the impossible. She mellowed a 250-pound Detroit Lion, a two-legged one, one of pro football's meanest tackles, and made him a Hollywood actor and a producer, and he's my other guest. And, oh, yes, in the process, they got married, which I think is wonderful.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Susan Clark.
Yes.
And Alex Karras. There he is, Alex Karras, the man. You have mellowed, Alex, since the first time I met you.
I don't know why everyone says that about me.
No, you have.
You think so?
Yeah, the first time I interviewed you, I was scared to death of him. I had seen him on the football field, I think. Gee, I got to say the right thing to him. He's liable to break me in half like a match or something. How did you transform him into what he is?
I just tired him out.
You did? Oh, you want to tell us about that?
Well, he had five children, and then we had another one, you know, a two-year-old will do it. A newborn baby, a two-year-old.
Little caboose you got, huh?
Then Alex said, well, this is ridiculous. Why should we sit around waiting for some agent to call and give us a job? He said, you're smart, you know about scripts and movies, and we have the same ideas. And he said, I know about the business, because I've been in the athletic business, and I've been in the car business, and the wrestling business.
Yeah.
And he said, we're going to start our own company. And we did.
Good for you.
Both had, much like your guest, Mr. Ted Turner, we both were fed up with the ugliness and the violence that we saw in not only the movies we watched, but the parts we were being given. So we decided to do movies about people. All kinds of people, all different backgrounds, and that's, I think, the best thing about television, people, the family
yeah.
situation, interaction, feelings, emotion, ideas.
Sure.
And it's not that difficult.
It isn't.
I mean, some of the most memorable.
They go on and on and on in this town about how difficult it is to do good things for television, and the basic bottom line is that most people are damn lazy about it. And they don't dig in and search and look for things that might help out.
Nobody really wants to work anymore.
No,
anyway.
No. And they're greedy. They don't want to put the money on the screen.
Everybody wants the most they can possibly get for the least amount of effort.
Yeah.
That's why that man that was sitting here is...
I think he's going to be a big, big force in this industry, and
indeed.
I salute him. I think it's terrific.
Boy, you guys have done some wonderful things of late. I saw the thing you did with the little... recently with the little black kid, and that was beautiful.
Yeah, that was our first production, and we liked that a lot, yeah.
It was really lovely.
Yeah.
And you, I'll never forget you, as Babe Dietrich.
Do you know what the last time we met in Philadelphia?
Yes, of course.
And you know what your producer wanted me to do? Jump hurdles outside the studio. And I
slept
all the way.
You don't even have to tell me his name. I know his name. It was crazy.
The only time I went, I said, I'll go to Philadelphia. I don't know about Philadelphia except W.C. Fields, and it's got a big bell, but I'll go to Philadelphia because I like Mike Douglas. He's got a good show. So I got on my train, and I schlepped from New York. And
the train? You took the train?
From New York, you see, and I had my little film clip, and your very classy company had a big car. I never saw Philadelphia from the station to the car. And he said, listen, we have had this great idea. See these hurdles? I said, yes. I said, well, it's not supposed to rain when we're doing the show. And Mike and I thought it would be a great idea.
Mike and I, he always
gave
me the heat. A bad name.
He said, we thought we'd just set up these hurdles.
I didn't know a thing
about it. Did you bring your running shoes? I said, now, wait a minute. I'm here as a girl. See, I have pretty clothes on and my pearls. And I just want to talk to Mike Douglas about Babe and all this. I don't want to do hurdles. He looked really hurt.
He could not take no for an answer, this fellow. You both have a power in your latest project, Made in America.
Yeah.
Was it hard to produce and act?
Yes,
No. Yes and no.
Yeah. What's the no part of it? What's the negative?
Well, as the actor, you know, you always want to do what you think it might be the better scene, and so you'd like to take another shot at a scene. And as a producer, you put the other hat on and you say, it's enough already, you know? We can't afford it. But and we had a big, big problem with the first thing we did with the scene. We didn't know whether we were going to add it or not, and it cost $17,000 to add it. So we had to conference, and we finally decided to do it. And it's difficult.
It's a bit like
sometimes.
Vegas.
Did it work?
Yeah, it did.
It was worth it.
That's interesting that you would say that. I sat at dinner. I'm not dropping names. But I happened to be at Sidney Sheldon's house one night, and Sidney Poitier was sitting next to me, and he had just done that enormously successful picture with Richie Pryor mm-hmm. and Gene Wilder.
Yeah.
And I said, Sidney, what is it about movies that you can be in there with people that you believe in who are great, and you're all the best people, and it's all going along smoothly, and yet you really don't know until It's up on a screen, it's edited, and the public sees it, whether it's a hit or not. I said, it really is a crapshoot. And he said, absolutely.
Yes, it is.
You do not know. I said, were you aware that that picture was going to exceed $100 million? He said, I had no idea in the world.
I think you can get it's tough with a comedy.
Oh, yes.
It's the toughest, and that's what Made in America is. It's a comedy.
And we like it, and we think it's terrific, and we've had it, you know, screened lots of times, and lots of people have seen it, including the network people, and everyone loves it.
You're the maid, right?
Yes, but it doesn't mean a thing unless the ratings are high, unless
exactly.
you get into the ratings. So it's kind of a crapshoot.
It's also going back to a period that is relevant today because of the economic situation. It's almost 11% unemployed and everybody's scared. It's a comedy that Frank Capra might have made, or Preston Sturges, about two different people, two different cultures. I am a fourth generation, the movie was made in Atlanta, legal family, liberal legal lawyers, a lot of judges. And they're crazy, those people, you know. We have a black maid who was mugged by a white man who made racial remarks, and the family is so upset, and she had a nervous breakdown, that we send her to Freudian analysis 5 days a week. Well, you know that Freudian analysis, you have to write down your dreams, and because the black maid didn't dream at night, she had to nap in the afternoon so she could write down her dreams for the doctor. So after she wrote down the dreams and went to the doctor, there was nobody to look after the two kids and my grandmother and my aunt and my father, and I'm working full-time, so we had to hire a maid. So guess who applied for the job? And even though I'm a big feminist, you know, liberal lawyer fighting and changing precedents in law, I don't want a man in my drawers and my closets. I mean, I want a personal lady's maid. He gets mad and he takes me to court.
I'm from the Midwest, and I'm a farmer, and I've raised seven sisters, and I've taken care of a mother all my life, so I feel qualified.
I love that. That's wonderful.
And the only reason that she says that she won't take me on is because I'm a man, and I'm basically a very honest person, and I say, that's not good enough, lady. You know, and so I take her to court on it.
We have a film clip.
Yes.
It doesn't have to be explained,
no.
Does it? Okay, would you roll it, Terry, please? Let's take a look.
You're doing, Mr. Bullington?
Oh, hi, Mrs. Abel. I'm just airing out your spring clothes like I did for my mom and my sisters every year.
Hours with me anymore. Who cares?
Well, can you hang around? We're coming right back. Susan Clark and Alex Garris, right after this.